All right, we are very pleased and proud to welcome everybody to the 97th annual Harris Hill Ski Jumping Competition. Ski jumpers from around the U.S. and the world will be competing here today to be the winner of the famed Winged Ski Trophy and the Fred Harris Memorial Tournament.
So starting off with the women's junior class, we have Caroline Harrison, Elise Loescher, Sophia Nestor from Park City, Utah, Alexa Barbeck from Steamboat Springs, Colorado, Tess Arnone from Steamboat Springs, Molly Emmons from Park City, Utah, Rachel Harder from Park City, Utah, Jillian Ifill from Park City, Samantha McCuga, also from Park City. We have a strong Park City connect representation here today. Anna Hoffman, also from Park City, Utah. These girls are all part of the women's national team. And the Annika Belshaw from Steamboat Springs Winter Sports Club, the winner of yesterday's competition. Then we now have the men's junior class from NYSF Lake Placid, New York. We have Jack Lawrence. From the Norgi Ski Club, we have Jacob Fuller. And then from just up the road in Lebanon, New Hampshire, we have Cameron Summerton. And from Lake Placid, we have Cameron Forbush. And from Salisbury, Connecticut, the lone Salisbury jumper here today, we have Seth Gardner. Then from based near Chicago, Illinois, the Norgi Ski Club, we have Maxim Glivka. Nephew of the famed Vladimir Glivka, who's won this trophy. Now we have from the Cloquet Ski Club, Aiden Rip. Then we have young Tate France from Lake Placid, New York. And also from Lake Placid, New York, we have Bryce Clock. Then from the Flying Eagle Ski Club, Landon Lee. And from Park City, Utah, we have Zachary Seltzman. And from Steamboat, we have Nicholas Malasinski. Followed by Eric Belshaw, also from Steamboat. And then also another local guy from Hanover, New Hampshire, we have Evan Nichols. And our victor from yesterday's USA Men's Cup, we have Candon Wilkinson from Steamboat Springs. Now we have our first guest from Austria, Lukas Volkbinger. Let's give him a round of applause. These guys have traveled a long way to come here. Then from Slovenia, we have Jacques Sila. And then from Austria, Österreich, we have Xavier Eigner. And our current hill record holder and the champion from yesterday, from Slovenia, we have Vlats Pavlic. And our hometown hero, the craziest of them all, from right here in Brattleboro, Vermont, Spencer Knickerbocker. And ladies and gentlemen, that is our 2019 Fred Harris Memorial Tournament competitors for the day. Let's give them a round of applause. So, looks like they're getting back on the bar. We're getting, again, this is Caroline Harrison from Lake Placid, New York, back out on that bar.
On the hill! So,
make some noise for Caroline. She's new to this style jump. Right to that Pepsi logo, I think you might have won herself a Pepsi today.
35 meters.
This is Elise Loescher from NYSF. there. She goes to Northwood School. She, in her bio, she said that she's written many books. You know, I think she's also a producer.
58 meters on our last jumper.
58 meters for this.
Hey, don't forget that this is all being streamed live by Brattleboro Community Television, who are on the hill here providing this. Over 4,000 people off-site got to watch this, so hit your mobile device, find Brattleboro Community Television, and then, of course, share, because this is super exciting stuff.
All right, next up, number three, we have Samantha Esther from Park City, Utah. Telemark landing. So you saw that telemark landing that Sophia put in there. That is what you, the judges would like to see. 52 meters for Sophia. So that telemark landing gives them a stylish landing other than a two-footed landing, as if you were to just land it right straight normally. All right, next up, number four, Alexa Barbeck from Seabrook Springs Winter Sports Club. All right, she's still about on that bar. And
on the hill comes.
Let's make some noise for Alexa. There you go, getting down there. Got a little squirrely with the skis on her landing, but she's athletic and knows how to hold them.
66 meters.
Oh, double sixes. All right, bid number five next from Steamboat Springs as well. Her Alexa's teammate, we have Tess Arnone.
Waiting for the sign from her coach. You can see the coach on the right-hand side in that stand right at the bottom of the run just gave her. And here she comes on the hill. Let's make a little noise for her.
Excellent. She's a good up-and-coming jumper. She's got a lot of potential. All these girls have tons of potential. And these girls could be the next top women in our, actually in the whole world, to be honest.
59 meters.
These girls are still young and still improving, but these guys are girls and making tons of steps forward. Next up is number six, Molly Immons from Park City, Utah, also a member of this women's national development team.
Good, strong showing from the women today.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. It's awesome to have these women at this competition because this last Olympics was the first Olympics that women's ski jumping was added to the Olympics. So it's so exciting to see all these young women out here
on the hill
competing at this size jump. There we go.
And a half meters on that last jump.
All right, number seven on the bar next. We have Rachel Harder from Park City Ski Club. She's up there. She got fifth place yesterday's competition. She had distances of 71 and 70 meters yesterday.
On the hill.
Now, you mentioned yesterday, or just moments ago, that there's that coach's stand. There you go, getting down that hill, close to that 80-meter mark. Now, Pete, you just mentioned something about that coach's stand. Those coaches there are helping critique the athletes on what they're doing on the takeoff and what their in-run position looks like. They video it, they talk to the athletes, and make all the decisions.
77 meters.
All right. So now we have number eight, Jillian Highfield from Park City Ski Club. Out on that bar, waiting for that coach's flag, waiting for the green light from the judges.
Giving the sign, on the hill.
Nice. Ah, she took a little tumble. Luckily, we have that EMT staff there quickly. Getting there for her. All right, guys, let's give Dillian a round of applause. Let's wish her all the best of that. We've got awesome professional staff helping her out. One of the unfortunate possibilities of the sport, but she's a champion. She can push it.
Yeah, we don't ever like to see those kind of things happen, but unfortunately they do.
Yeah, it's a little unfortunate because sometimes this is a very safe sport, and you know, people think that might be crazy to hear that, but it's a super, super safe sport because you're going with the momentum of the hill. The hill's going down, but sometimes you just catch something a little wrong, catch the edge wrong, and it just catches you the wrong way.
Yeah, it looks like she got herself turned a little bit, caught a ski, went down, and again, you know, as you can see, it gives you an idea on how hard the surface is.
Yeah. But you know, it's like a nice balance between that, because you want to have a hard surface so, for example, you don't get a shoulder or an elbow or something that goes into the snow, which can catch and really cause some serious damage. But that hard surface, obviously there's a fine balance between it. You know, there's some dangers involved with a sport, but honestly that doesn't happen very often.
No.
So Pete, there's a really interesting thing, and I mention it all the time, but I really want people to understand how far that is. That the hill record is 104 meters. 104 meters, that is 341 feet. That is just amazing. So anyways, we have Samantha Bakuga from Park City now back on that bar, bib number 9. Let's make some noise for Samantha, let's cheer her on. They're up there waiting for the green light from the judges.
Got
the flag, and here she comes. Excellent jump up there. Down past that 70 meter mark. Excellent jump for Samantha. She got third place yesterday's competition. And now we're going to move to our second place finisher from yesterday's competition, Anna Hoffman, bib number 10 from Park City, Utah. She had jumps of 81 meters and 77 meters. So let's see if she can.
On the hill!
Down near that 80 meter mark. Right on the money, 80 meters. All right, guys, now put your hands together for the winners of yesterday's U.S. Women's Cup competition. We have bib number 11 from Steamboat Springs, Annika Belshoff. She had a jump of 89 meters yesterday. And she is looking to best that today.
On the hill!
Oh, yeah.
Woo!
Yeah! Down that hill.
85 and a half meters.
Excellent jump there for Annika. All right, that wraps up the first round of our women's junior class. And then we're going to go into our men's junior class. And we're going to adjust the start bar a little bit for these guys. And we're going to get a nice competition because some of these guys know how to climb. Hey, are you guys having a fun time today? You are, okay. Are you enjoying the warm weather? Are you staying warm?
Oh, yeah.
You're not too cold, right?
No.
Excellent, glad to see you're not getting too cold. Are you, what's your favorite part about ski jumping?
Going really far.
That is my favorite part about ski jumping as well. So
bib
next up,
20 on the bar,
we have Jack Lawrence from NYSEF, Lake Placid, New York. He's out on that start bar waiting for the flag from his coach, Colin Delaney.
On the hill!
Oh,
to Jumper Jack. He's newer to jumping these size jumps, so it's awesome to see him out here being a part of this competition, getting
46 meters.
46. And we have Jacob Fuller, bib number 21 from the Norton Ski Club. He is looking to best his trial around jump and making some improvements here. But he knows he wants to go
on the hill
in this first competition round of his. Oh, that looks a little better than his trial round.
Probably.
Next up, we have Cameron Summergen from Lebanon Outing Club. Just up the road from here, he's a local boy.
Here he comes.
Yes, make some noise for Cameron. There you go. Throwing his hands up in the air for cheering. Looks like he liked that jump.
53 and a half meters.
That's a solid first round jump for Cameron. And now we're going to move on to bib number 23. From Lake Placid, New York, Cameron Forbush.
On the hill.
Yeah, ended up there trying to break that 60-meter mark. And bib number 24, Seth Gardner, is getting onto the bar from Salisbury, Connecticut.
50 meters on our last jumper.
50 meters for Cameron.
So 54 meters.
54 meters, excuse me. So Seth Gardner is up next from Salisbury, Connecticut. He is also from around this area. He's got a wonderful 64-meter size ski jump down there. It's a great intermediate jump for all these up-and-coming kids.
On the hill.
I'll talk about a little bit. That's the jump to Seth. So, up next is bib number 25, Maxim Glivka from the Northeast Ski Club.
On the hill!
Better jump for Maxim. We're still waiting on Seth Gardner's distance. Doing some acrobatics in the outlet.
63 and a half meters.
Next up is Aiden Rip from the Cloquet Ski Club, bib number 26.
On the hill.
Here comes Aiden. He did a little head grab there. I wasn't sure if he was stoked or
75 meters.
Putting his helmet back on, but as long as he has his helmet on, we are okay with that. All right, we're moving on to next. Bib number 27, Tate Frantz from the NYSEF Ski Club based in Lake Placid, New York. These kids here have tons of potential, and you are possibly looking at future Olympians with all of these jumpers here. So it's awesome. So if you see them get their autographs and stuff before they're famous, it's going to be pretty cool. You might get a lot of money for them.
On the Hill!
There you go. That was a little better jump to take it down near that 80-meter mark.
Seventy-6.5 meters.
All right, next also his teammate from Lake Placid, New York, bib number 28, we have Bryce Clock. He's waiting for the flag from his coach, Colin Delaney.
On the Hill!
He wasn't quite sure how he felt about that jump.
69 meters.
69 for Bryce.
We did it together.
Looks like he might be trying a little too hard from down here. Okay, we're going to move on to bib number 29 from the Flying Eagle Ski Club, Landon Lee. He's just sliding right out onto that start bar right now. He's getting his skis in the track. So there's a track up there that these athletes are putting their skis in. And what they do is they ice it to make it as rock hard and solid as they can. And he skis this
on the hill.
The track. And it allows them to pick up to these speeds of 50, 60, 70, 50 miles an hour. Oh yeah, right down in that blue zone. Past that 80 meter mark for Landon.
80 meters.
All right, next up is number 30, Zach Seltzman from Park City, Utah. It's awesome to see how far these guys have traveled just to come here to this competition this weekend. How amazing is that?
On the hill.
Let's put your hands together. These guys have traveled a long way to get here. Oh yeah, we're getting down the hill now.
Meters.
Decent jump for Zach. Right close to that 80 meter mark. He's going to look to best that next round. Now we have bib 31. Nicholas Balasinski from Steamboat Springs, Colorado. These kids are
in on the hill.
These kid groups are about under 18 years of age. How awesome is that? I think we have from 12 to 18 year olds here. There we go. Nicholas Balasinski throwing it down right near that red line. He is here to play today, ladies and gentlemen. He means business. Still waiting on that distance. Here comes Eric Belshaw. He got second place. This could be far jump, ladies and gentlemen. That was decent right down near that blue line. Still waiting on that distance for Nicholas Malasinski, but that was Eric Belshaw from Seabrook Springs Winter Sports Club.
84 meters on that last jump.
84 for Eric Belshaw. And the person who got third place yesterday's U.S. Cup competition is bib number 33, local man from Hanover, New Hampshire, skiing for the Fort Sayre Ski Club, Evan Nichols. Let's make some noise for him. He can go.
On the hill.
This is the last of this skier category. He knows how to throw down. Oh, right down near that red line as well. We're getting a tight competition between Nicholas Balasinski, Eric Belshaw and Evan Nichols. We're going to have a close race going into the second round. More competition, not, I guess it's not technically a race. Waiting on the distance for Evan Nichols.
86 meters.
Ooh, everyone's getting closer and closer to that red line. And what we're doing now, we're actually, that was the end, the last jumper of the men's junior class. And now we're going to move into the older division, the open class. This is where we got some of our strongest jumpers of the day. This is where we have some of our Europeans that know how to do it. And this is where we have our hill record holder of 104 meters, Blas Pavlich. So it's going to be awesome to see what these guys can do, because these guys in the training jump really threw down some far jumps, and it's going to be exciting. So make sure you guys cheer them on and make some noise. Ring those cowbells.
Remember, this whole event is being streamed on Brattleboro Community Television out to the world. So when they come down, make a little noise so folks in Austria can hear you, please.
Yeah, and if you follow them on Facebook, or if you follow Harris Hill on Facebook, or USA Nordic on Facebook, make sure you also share that viewership.
On the hill!
Here we go. We have Cannon Wilkinson, the winner of the junior class yesterday, the US Cup yesterday. He can go. There it is, right down near that red line. He knew he had a little bit more than that. He knew he had something else in that one a little bit. He got a little bit of a squirrely at the end of his flight, and he had to come down a little sooner than he wanted, but he knew he had a good jump. But that set the bar very
high. 90 meters.
Oh, yeah. There we go. Breaking that red line, passing that K point. That's the size of this ski jump, 90 meters. That is a good jump. So every jump past that gets more and more difficult to land as the ground gets flatter and flatter. All right, next we have bib number 37 from Austria. Let's give him a warm welcome, Lucas Volkelbinger. He had a far jump in his trial round, and let's see if he can do that again. I think it was 97 meters in his trial jump, so this could be awesome.
On the hill!
Here he comes.
Make some noise!
Right around that 90 meter mark, right around that red line. He's not quite pleased with that jump. However, that was pretty cool.
89.5 meters.
Oh, we're getting a nice race up here in this open class. And now we're gonna move on to bib number 38 from Slovenia. Zach Hill. These guys know how to fly. There are tons of ski jumps in Slovenia,
as well in Austria, and these guys have great training facilities, and it's awesome that these guys come here to come train and compete on this jump for you guys this weekend. So let them know how excited you are to have them here.
I know!
How long it's come here. That red line. That's awesome. We're excited to see that distance. Definitely past that red line.
94 meters.
That's the longest jump this round so far. And now we move over to our second place finisher of yesterday's competition from Austria. We have Xavier Agner. Let's make some noise for him. They love hearing the cheering and the bells and everything on top. It pumps them up. It pushes them to go further, and they want to go far.
Waiting for the sign from his coach. Again, you can see him on the right side, right at the end of the ramp. Arms up, and then he drops that, your jumper can go. There he goes. He's on the hill. All right.
looks like we might have our longest.
There you go. He gave a little fist pump at the bottom there. He was pretty excited at that.
96 meters.
96. Oh, my goodness. All right, we're getting way down this hill. This is awesome. I love seeing this stuff. This is so cool, seeing these guys fly this far. All right. Up next, putting his skis on currently. Looking at the hill, knowing what he has to do. This is our hill record holder with a jump a couple years ago of 104 meters. He is looking to put jumps down similar to that today and to take home that Fred Harris Memorial Trophy as he slides out onto that bar. We have bib number 40 from Slovenia, Zlat Pavlic. Let's make some noise for him. Let's have him hear you. Let's do it.
The more noise you make, pushes air up that hill, carries it further to us.
Come on. Let's hear him on. He's waiting for that.
On the hill, makes the noise.
Nonchalantly, like he knew what he did. He was liking that one.
One 100 meters.
Look at that, triple digits. That is awesome. Oh yeah, that set the longest jump of the day for us today. So that was awesome. He's currently most likely sitting in first place off my best guesses and expertise. But we have one more jumper, because that was the end of the open round. Now we go into the very tough, very difficult, very competitive master's class with a total competitor number of one. And we have our local hometown hero, our local legend, the most world-renowned, famous, crazy man of them all. That is Mr. Spencer Knickerbocker from right here in Brattleboro. He skis for the Marlboro Nordic Ski Club. He goes to school right at Marlboro College. He's one of the locals, so he loves to pump the crowd up. He also loves to hear you guys cheer him on, and he is ready to go.
All right, we have a correction from the judges' tower in our last jumper. That was 102 meters.
Whoa! Whoa! Oh, yeah, that's awesome. I love seeing that. I love the corrections. Just making sure those distances are right. That's what those judges and officials do.
Next time they should just ask me, Nick. I had it at 102 the whole time.
Yeah. You might have a new job next year, Nick.
Looks cold out there.
And thank you for all those hill markers on the side of the hill. We appreciate what you're doing. Spencer Knickerbocker. However, he knew that wasn't quite exactly what he was looking for, but he's excited that that's probably going to leave him in first place after this first round.
84 and a half meters for Spencer.
He knows he can do better, and he's going to be doing that next time. He's going to be looking for this next jump, this next competition. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that was the end of the first competition round. We are going to get the results in from this first competition round, set up the start list, and get those athletes back to the top of the jump in about 20 minutes.
All right, looks like we're sliding out onto
the
bar.
We're out on the bar now. On the hill!
This is from Lake Placid, New York, Caroline Harrison. She's just new to this side ski jump, so she is just figuring this stuff out, which is awesome. So it's so cool to see her out here doing this stuff. I am excited to see how she progresses and grows in the future.
37 meters.
That was much, much better improvement for Caroline.
35 meters, sorry.
Very consistent result from Caroline. And
on the hill
is Sophia Nestor from Park City Ski Club. There we go.
...57 meters on our last jump.
Okay, we're gonna move on to our third competitor this round. Elise Loescher from NYSEF. She is also one of these young and up-and-coming women who, if she keeps to it, will have a strong chance at becoming one of the U.S.'s top jumpers, like many of these women in this class.
On the hill. All right, now we've got some kids on the left side of the outrun, down by the van. If we could just get you guys down closer to the van, that would be helpful. We need to keep that area clear. Thank you.
All right, our next jumper is Tess Arnone from Steamboat Springs Winter Sports Club. He's waiting for that flag from the coaches, getting that green light.
We'll be right back.
74 and a half meters.
All right, that was our third place jumper, Rachel Harder. And now we're going to go into currently sitting second place. Going into the second round, we have Anna Hoffman
on the hill,
Park City, Utah. She, there you go.
Wow, put it right down there.
Movement.
Meters.
There we go. Good 1 meter improvement for Anna Hoffman. And that just leaves our final woman of our women's junior class, who currently won the U.S. Cup yesterday for the women's division. With a jump of 85 and a half meters the first round, we have Annika Belshaw. She's got a commanding lead, however, the pressure can get to people at times. We'll see if she has that.
On the hill!
We'll see if she has that Tom Brady-like focus.
Oh, that thing spit her right out.
Oh, look at that. Right down that hill, putting that tall mark in, showing that off, making sure the judges see that.
86 meters!
There we go, excellent jump for Annika. Right down that hill. Speaking of Tom Brady, I see a ton of Patriots gear. If anyone's wearing Patriots gear out there, let's make some noise. Let's just congratulate the Pats on this Super Bowl win. There we go. I heard a funny thing that ski jumpers are a very unique bunch. And everyone said that, like, well, Tom Brady, or like, you can throw a football, but Tom Brady can't go off this jump. So, you know. We like to think ski jumpers are a little sometimes more special than Tom Brady. By a little bit. I love Tom Brady, nothing wrong with him. All right, now we're moving on to a men's junior class. And we have a tight race in the top three here. All the competitors in the top three in the junior class are within 4 points and 3.5 points of each other. So this is awesome. And then we also got some new up-and-coming juniors that are just getting introduced to hills that are this size. So it's super cool to have these guys that are competing against some talented young men, as well as some up-and-coming people that are really here enjoying this experience. Because I'm enjoying this experience. Is everyone else enjoying this experience? Yeah.
There we go. There we go.
So we adjusted the start bar to gate 16 up there for these junior jumpers, these junior men jumpers. Now they're going to get the athletes to get their skis on. And our first athlete for the junior class is going to be Jack Lawrence from NYSEP. Hey, all those hill markers on the side of the hill in the blue jackets, let's get a wave from you guys. Let's wave it if you can hear us. There we go. Everyone give the hill markers a round of applause. They're here out helping, along with all these other volunteers. I just wanted to see you guys wave so you make sure you're not frozen up there. So, you're still alive. Got to see that. Thank you. All right, looks like we're having Jack get out on that bar.
All right, we're getting ready to start back up here. Draw your attention to the top of the hill.
He's waiting for his flag.
On the hill!
Oh, that looks better. We're waiting on the distance for Jack.
46 and a half meters.
Making a small improvement of a half meter there for Jack. Awesome job. And next up, We're going to go back to the top of the hill with Jacob Fuller, from the Norgi Ski Club. All right, it's Jacob Fuller's up on the top.
On the hill!
Flag, he's got it.
Nice looking jump.
There he goes.
Meters.
All right, next we have a local boy just from up the road in Lebanon, New Hampshire. We have a Cameron Summerton. So let's make some noise for Cameron. He's one of these local kids from around the area.
All right, just waiting for a sign from his coach to send him.
Green light.
Looks like he's got it. And he is on the hill. Make some noise for him.
There we go. Decent jump for Cameron.
57 meters.
So we have Jumper the Cow running around and outrunning around. If you see Jumper the Cow, take some photos with him. Anyone that makes more noise than Jumper the Cow and celebrates more than Jumper the Cow, I have a little prize for you if you can prove that you make more noise and more enthusiastic than Jumper the Cow. And next up, we have bib number 23, Cameron Forbush, also from NYSEF,
or on the hill,
Lake Class in New York. Making a little improvement on his jump there from his trial round, or first round, which is awesome to see.
60 meters.
60 meters. That's a great little improvement of 6 meters there for Cameron. And now we are going to go to bib number 24 from Salisbury, Connecticut, Seth Gardner.
On the hill.
Getting down past that 60-meter mark. Getting some improvement there.
62 and a half meters.
Excellent. Good little solid improvement there for Seth. Now we are moving on to family member of the famed Vladimir Glivka, the previous winner of this Fred Harris Memorial Trophy, his nephew, Maxim Glivka, from the Norgi Ski Club in Chicago, near Chicago.
On the hill!
Let's see what he can do. Let's clear him on. Got a little jump there for Maxim. He likes sliding out on the outrun a little bit.
69 meters.
A solid 69 meters there for Maxim with a good improvement. Now we are moving on to Lake Placid native, or lives just outside of Lake Placid technically. Bib number 28, Bryce Locke, who also had a jump of 69 meters.
On the hill!
Let's see if he can improve it. That was a much better jump for Bryce there. He still doesn't know how to think of it, but it's good to see what he had.
73 meters.
73 meters there for him. I know he might not have liked that. No, he wants to jump like 110 meters on this jump. He really wants it. But he'll get there eventually. And so, next from the Clockhead Ski Club, bib number 26, we have Aiden Rip, someone who jumped 75 meters in his first round. I really think he can break that 80-minute mark.
Yep.
And let's get him on. Here he comes.
On the hill.
There we go. Aiden's going down the hill. He's got that flow coming out of his helmet. He's loving it. He knew he was getting improved on that jump.
80 meters.
80 meters, Aiden. Right on the money. Good improvement for him. And it looks like everyone's making solid improvements this round. I like seeing this. So we have another kid that knows how to fly. He has a very beautiful style in the air. If you look up at the top of the jump from Lake Placid, New York, bib number 27, Kate Brunks
on the hill.
He's looking to get down that hill. There it is. Very similar, very consistent jump from the first round. A little hop in the outrun down there. This kid likes to jump.
77 meters.
77 meters. Great 1 meter improvement for Tate from his first round. From Park City, Utah, coached by the famed Anders Johnson and Blake Hughes.
That's a nice jump.
Down near that blue line, near that 80 meter mark. And so as a reminder, these athletes are coming off this jump
77 and a half meters,
55 miles an hour. You know, so just imagine sticking your hand outside the window in your car when you're driving on the highway and move your hand around. If you pull it up too hard, that's too much resistance. You put it down too low, it pulls your hand down. But if you find that nice balance, you can get your hand to float. And this is kind of what these ski jumpers are trying to do. So, next up from the Flying Eagle Ski Club, we have Landon Lee, who had a solid jump of 80 meters.
On the hill!
There we go, looks like a small improvement there for Landon. Wasn't quite sure of it, he was wanting more.
80 meters.
It's very consistent jumping today. 2 80 meter jumps for Landon.
And don't forget, when all of our jumping is done here, when the competition jumping is done, of course, we'll be doing our target jump, taking the top 10 from the day on the hill. And of course, trying to paint a target right around 95 meters.
And this is Eric Belshaw going right down that hill. Eric's putting some pressure on. We have, remember, the guys, this one's the top three. He's currently sitting in third place after that first round. And these guys are all within 3 points of each other.
84 meters.
84 meters, you put a nice solid, consistent jump down. So he's telling everyone back up the hill, you gotta make this yourself. He's not giving them anything. So now we have from Hanover, New Hampshire, kind of a local boy from this area, Evan Nichols. Let's give him a round of applause. Let's cheer him on down. He is.
Coach has given him the sign, and he is on the hill.
Currently sitting second place, and he's only a half a point behind the lead. So let's see what he can do. There it is. Been a solid jump down there, right down near that K point. Wasn't quite sure. He knows there's still that option. It's going to make
87 and a half meters.
Oh, yeah. I made a little improvement there for Evan. But that tells Nicholas Malasinski, currently sitting in first place after that first round, that he has got to do some work to maintain that lead. But will Evan Nichols throw him off the current leaderboard spot?
Yes.
So, from Steamboat Springs, we have Nicholas Malasinski on that bar, waiting for his coach's flag.
He's got it, and he's on the hill.
Let's go, let's see if he can take home the win. That's up there. Oh, that left the door open. I'm not sure how that goes. That's going to be close to call. I don't know if I can make a judgment on that one.
85 and a half meters.
Ooh, this is going to be close. This junior class. That just ended the junior class with the top three jumpers very close to each other. Very consistent jumps. So it'll be interesting, and it's going to come down to style points. And this is where, when people jump similar distances, those style points and those telemark landings play a huge role.
You know something, Nick? We've got jumpers from far and wide here. We're always fortunate to pull those folks in. We've got people here from far and wide. We've even got a couple of those thin-blooded Floridians here today. I'm getting a text. So I want to give a shout out to Bridget and Mallory Horgich, who are hanging out over at the beer tent, trying to stay warm, even though it's warm for us.
Ah, it's warm for us.
It's not so warm for them.
People feel warm and all.
So a big shout out to Bridget and Mallory.
And I would also like to make an announcement too that it is one of the coaches from Steamboat Springs' birthday today, Carl Denny. So we just want to say happy birthday to Carl Denny, one of the coaches.
All right, this is our...
So now, okay, ladies and gentlemen, we move into our open class. And we are going to go with yesterday's winner in the U.S. Cup division. We are going to go with Camden Wilkinson.
On the hill.
He jumped 90 meters, ladies and gentlemen. These people are the ones that fly. This could be down there. There you go. That was a good little whiplash right there you got. But it looks like he's up.
All right, looks like he's up. They're just going to go down and check on him.
He got a little shaken up there.
All right.
But he's up, standing around. They're just going to check him over, make sure he's all right. There's also a ski still in the R2. Glad to see him. He's up walking around.
All right.
He knew he wasn't a fan of that one. He knew he had a little more in that, and he was upset that he caught an edge on that one. But we're just going to check the hill, make sure there's no
86 meters there. On that last jump.
We got that medical personnel checking them out, making sure everything's good. We got Kenny down there, making sure the landing hill's all good for everyone, making sure it's still safe for everyone. And it looks like it's still good to go. See, you can see how quickly that stuff kind of happens, just with a little bit, but it happens very rarely.
All right, so Bib 37 making his way out onto the bar.
So this is our first Austrian, currently sitting in fourth place with a jump of 89 meters. This is Lucas Wolfinger, traveled all the way from Austria here. These guys can jump far, so let's see what these guys can do up here. Let's give a round of applause and cheer on our international visitors.
On the hill!
Oh yeah, he's got some height. Right down near that red line, the K point. We are waiting on that distance for Lucas. He had a first round jump of 89.5 meters and his second round jump.
All right, again, remember, stick around because this is, as fun as all this is, they completely take the chain off, remove the leash, and let these guys go for the target jumping. Last round, 10 jumpers, all shooting for a target, which is set at about 95 meters. Closest to the target without going over wins.
Okay, now we have something really cool coming up. One, we have number 38 from Slovenia, Jacques Sila, from... with a jump of 94 meters in the first round. So these guys are the top three jumpers in our open class. So
he's on the hill!
Currently in third place. Let's see if he can move up some positions. He's got a solid jump up there, getting down that hill. Woo! It's that red line. Excellent job from Jacques. Oh yeah, that was close to that red.
94.5 meters.
Good improvement. And so we're gonna go on to currently sitting second place with a jump of 96 meters in the first round from Austria, Xavier Eigner. He is up there. He knows he has to go put some effort down to catch the current person sitting in first place, which is Blas. Pavlich from Slovenia. He knows he has to throw a solid jump down here.
And you're going to need to make plenty of noise for this guy.
Yeah, these guys are some of the best jumpers we have here today. So let's make some noise.
Waiting for the sign from his coach, which he has, and he is on the hill.
There we go. Oh, yeah. Right down, right deep in that red zone. He's clapping. He knows he liked that jump. He had a nice telemark landing. The judges are going to like that landing. He was a nice flight.
95 meters.
95 and a half meters for Xavier.
So the official, looks like we're going to have the top eight and the entire open class on the target chute. Right at the end.
Oh, awesome. So we're taking the top jumpers from
top
today.
Top jumpers and the whole entire open class.
And the entire open class. And everyone's going to go back up. And they are going to go fight for the target jump. And the winner takes home. Winner takes all. Winner takes home $250.
And you know what? I mean, yesterday, was it came right down
it
to the very
right
last jumper.
Last jumper. And he landed right on the mark. And that was awesome. And then he only had a second person. The second had 94 and a half.
94 and a half.
He had half a meter to land on the target.
I'm not sure what our target will be. Hopefully it'll be the chalk outline of the dead body.
So, ladies and gentlemen, if you turn your eyes up to the top of the hill, we have the hill record holder from Slovenia.
Oh, yeah.
Brock Pavlich.
Get excited. Here he comes.
In the first round, a jump of 102 meters. He knows how to fly. Let's see him down there. Woo! That was awesome. Down close to that 100-meter mark. Maybe close. We're waiting to hear still from the judges. From
98 meters.
98 meters for Brock Pavlich. That looks like he might have secured the victory here in that open class, which is awesome that he might be getting his name on that winged fame, that famed winged Harrison, Fred Harris trophy, excuse me.
That one.
That trophy.
We know it.
All right, guys, now we have the local legend, the man himself, the all-seeing, the all-knowing, local hero, Spencer Knickerbocker. Who goes to college right here in Marlboro, Vermont. And he grew up and is from right here in Brattleboro. So let's cheer him on. He's the last jumper today in this competition round before our target jump. So he loves you guys to make noise. Let's make some noise for him. Here he comes. Let's make some noise. Yeah. There you go, Spencer. Not quite what he was thinking of, but he still wants everyone to make some noise.
Yeah, give it up for him. Spencer Knickerbocker.
Ladies and gentlemen, 70, let's make some noise.
78 meters.
Let's make some noise for all of those competitors here today in the competition.
Remember, stick around. Our target jumping.
Yep.
Until next, that's super exciting. You don't want to miss a single jump.
And that will be in about 20 minutes, and we're going to set a target somewhere near that 95 meter mark, plus or minus. Might not be exactly 95 today. We'll see what the judges come up with. And so, ladies and gentlemen, the rules of the target jump is the athlete gets to determine how much speed they want to take themselves. There's no judges, no officials telling them or preventing them on how much speed they can take. But here's the caveat. If you go over the target distance, you are disqualified. So you can go, it's price of right rules. It's on the money or lower. You cannot go over. So, and the winner is going to take home a big $250. So, these guys, these athletes are going to get organized, get all set up, get their equipment all set up, and they will probably jump again in about 20 minutes. Oh, okay, so now it's Eric Belshaw, actually. Annika's brother up there at... He is taking some speed up there. That distance.
Remember that, I was trying to hit that 95 meter mark.
There it is. Oh! Getting down near that red line. Not quite there. He knew he had a little bit more distance to go for that, but not a bad effort.
86 meters, about 9 meters short.
All right, now we have Annika Belshaw, bib number 11, Eric Belshaw's sister. So she is the only woman up there right now competing against all these men in this competition. So let's make some noise for her. She knows she has to get down that hill, right to that 95 meter mark. Her brother set an 86 meter distance.
On the hill, a little sibling rivalry
here.
Let's
make some noise. Came down a little sooner than she liked, right around that 80 meter mark.
A little squirrely.
She didn't quite get it to the target, but she did take home the W in the women's class. So that is awesome, Veronica. Congratulations. Give her a round of applause. Still waiting to hear that distance. However, so that was around 80 meters for Annika.
Hey, you're pretty good, Nick. 80 meters. You ever done this before?
Right now, those guys at the top of the hill are hearing the distances weren't quite as far as everyone else thought, so they're just making the thoughts, the little calculations, physics calculations in their head. All right, now next up is Aiden Rip, bib number 26. He had some jumps.
On the hill!
Let's make some noise. He can make it to that. He just needs to go. He felt like he was trying to pull out a little bit there, and he might have came out a little bit slow or a little bit sooner than he thought.
85 meters.
For Aiden. And again, ladies and gentlemen, this is a winner takes all. Whoever is closest without going over that target of 95 meters. So these guys, they're starting to feel some pressure now. They're trying to figure out what they need to do, how much speed they need to take, how hard they need to jump. So next up is bib number 31, Nicholas Malasinski. He had some great jumps earlier today.
On the hill!
And he's got some speed with him to go right now, so let's see what he can do. Coming up a little bit short, just past that 80 meter mark.
Meters.
Not quite there for Nicholas Malasinski, but we are starting to get into that open class up there. But first, we're waiting on the number of this athlete.
On the hill!
We're not exactly sure who this is right yet, but let's cheer him on down the hill. Right down near that 80 meter mark. Another round. Oh, that looked like Evan Nichols. He might have gotten a little bit squirrely off the takeoff there.
85 meters.
85, there it is. Got a little squirrely, didn't really hit that takeoff well, so he came off a little unbalanced, didn't get that air pressure, and wasn't quite as efficient as he wanted to be with that air, catching that air with his skis and his body, so.
So moving the bar down to 15, Nick, what does that mean?
So we're moving the bar down. What that means is that some of this next skiers don't want to have as much speed to go into this jump because their skill level might be at a certain level that allows them to jump far with less speed. So if they add more speed, they might out jump that target.
Okay.
So, and this is where that little, that trying to figure out, know how your jumping's going, know how everything's working out. And then also trying to balance to give yourself enough speed that if you don't hit the jump just right, you might not go as far as you need. So you're trying to find that nice balance. And next up from Austria, bib number 37, Lukas Vogelbinger.
He is on the bar, one of our friends from Austria. So let's cheer him on, ladies and gentlemen.
On the hill.
There it is. Oh, yeah, down past that red line.
All right. That's probably our longest so far.
I would say that's the closest one yet.
91 meters.
91, right past that red line for Lucas. Currently sitting in first place for that $250. But let's see what the rest of the people at the top of the jump have to say.
Jumpers left. We have three jumpers left.
All right, next up we have 39, also from Austria, Xavier Eigner.
On the hill.
Let's make some noise for him. He knows that he can come and put it down there. He had a jump there today earlier.
Oh, he's pushing. He's close.
That was right around that area. They're still waiting to hear the official mark.
But 94 meters.
There it is for Xavier, setting the bar high.
Is it going to come down to the last jumper again, Nick?
I believe so. We have now, what, two remaining at the top
two
of the hill?
Two remaining.
Two jumpers remaining at the top of this hill. They're both vying for that $250. And remember, if you over-jump it, you are disqualified.
But we thank you.
But we thank you, because it's really fun and exciting to watch. So if you're going to go over-jump it, keep going. You know, and we want to see even further jumps. And next up is Big Bib 38 from Slovenia. There's Jacques Sila that he is looking for and trying to figure out what start gate he wants to work from. But it looks like he's figured that out. He's sliding out onto that start bar. He's out there. He's got his coaches over there in that judge's tower looking at the win for him, determining what they need to do. But this is going to be close. This is going to be close.
All right, so right now, 94 meters takes home the prize. Two jumpers left. We got to wait and see what happens. And he's on the hill.
Let's make some noise for him, ladies and gentlemen. Let's go.
Oh, he's got a good one.
He wants it. Yeah, there you go. He was very close. Well, let's see, was it too far? Was it just under? Or was it right on the mark? He was raising his hands. He's pumping it up. He wants people to make some noise for him.
95 meters.
There we go. On the mark for Jacques. And you know what that means? The next skier, who I believe is Blaz Pavlic, the hill record holder of 104 meters, he just heard that he has to go exactly 95 meters to tie this up. And then maybe we have a battle royale at the bottom of the hill, or maybe an extra jump. We will figure out to see what they are, what they do. Maybe a solid rock, paper, scissors game. We're not sure. We're just as excited and clueless as you. So here comes Blaz sliding out onto the bar. He knows that he has to go 95 meters, but he had jumps earlier today of 102 meters and 98 meters in the competition. So now, here he comes.
So close.
He was right on the money. Wasn't quite sure. Might have come up a little short on that. We're going to get the official distance. However, I don't think it was quite there, and I think he knew it wasn't quite there. So, just waiting for the confirmation.
94 meters!
Oh, that was a close one, ladies and gentlemen. Two jumps of 94 meters from Xavier and Blaz, but the champion of the target jump with a jump of exactly 95 meters is Jacques Sila from Slovenia. Bring it home, that 250 big ones. I'm sure you can get it converted over to euros on your flight home on Monday. So, awesome. Ladies and gentlemen, let's give a round of applause for all those athletes and competitors. And
all right, everybody.
Thank you.
Thank you once again
for all those volunteers and the officials and everyone here that made this event possible. Thank you very, very much. I hope you guys have a wonderful, wonderful day.
All right, everybody. Thank you for coming out. We'll see you at year 98. Gonna get a yeah. All right, everybody. Our first round of awards will be going to the Nordic Combined.
Yeah.
And for the men, I'm looking for third place finisher, Eric Belshaw. Eric Belshaw, come on down. All right, here comes Eric. In second place, Nicholas Malashinsky. Nicholas Malashinsky in second place for the Nordic Combined. And finishing in first place for the men's Nordic Combined, Evan Nichols. Give it up for them. A nice round of applause, please, for today's Nordic Combined. Thank you, gentlemen. For the women, in second place, Alexa Brabeck. And in first place, Tess Arnone. Arnone. Thank you. Sorry, Tess. All right, give it up for our women's Nordic Combined. Thank you, ladies. All right, and for today's winner in the juniors men's division, coming in third place, Eric Belshaw. In second place, Nicholas Malashinsky. And in first place, Evan Nichols. Up next for today's winner are the women's junior division. And I'm looking for Rachel Hardier. Herder. Thank God I've got a translator out here. In second place, Anna Hoffman. And in first place today, Annika Belshaw. Thank you, ladies.